Yeah, thank you, sir. Thank you very much. First of all, I heartily, welcome you all for my presentation, and I have to thank special thank to Dr. Vinayak sir for giving me this opportunity at the last moment to present this topic. Before I start with the topic, I have to just brief you that I have presented this paper on my small work, which was done on adolescence. So the title of my presentation is "Effect of Yoga on Cognitive Functions Among Adolescents." Me, Dr. Lavia Shetty from Division of Yoga, Manipal. So next slide, please. So I'll go to the brief introduction about what is the mental health. Mental health is a state of well-being in which the individual realizes his or her ability, which can cope with the normal stresses of life, work productivity, and make a contribution to community. Next slide, please. Memory, attention, language production, and comprehensive learning, problem-solving, reasoning, and decision-making are the example of cognitive performance, which is very important for adolescents. Adolescents' cognitive development is influenced by various variety of factors, including the psychosocial environment, socioeconomic status, nutrition, family, and environmental factors. The cognitive mechanism required for goal-directed cognition and actions are referred to as executive function. The recent study shows that aerobic exercises improves children's executive function. The next slide. So we opted yoga. As you know, yoga is an ancient traditional practice that involves mind and body activity. It incorporates not only physical posture, breathing technique, meditative activity, which brings not only the physical, mental, and emotional wellness and also togetherness. As the definition of yoga suggests, the union of jivatma with paramatma, that is, the union of individual self with the transcendental self. It is beneficial in the yoga is also beneficial in enhancing mental health and consequently cognitive growth. It is reported that regular practice of yoga has reduced stress and also help in improving the academic performance in school children. Next slide, please. Yoga has multiple benefit, as everybody know now, that it improves the mental health, it increases muscle strength, flexibility, improves the respiratory function, cardiac parameter, reduction of anxiety, stress, depression, also improves the sleep, improves quality of life. Along with all these benefits, we have also certain benefits for, as in it automatically massages the internal organ, improves digestive function, circulatory function, respiratory function, endocrine, neurological, and excretory system. Next slide, please. In the current era, we all know that it is technology-based and technology-driven, so there is general lack of physical activity, especially in school-going children. Hence, there is a need to incorporate a structured program that is cost-effective and easily incorporated into daily activity. Considering all these multiple benefits of yogic practice, we developed a small yoga module which can be readily incorporated in daily activity. Our study aims to evaluate the effectiveness of yoga intervention of cognitive ability of adolescents. Next slide, please. So our material and subjects will go through all these things one by one. We have used tools like digital span forward and digital span backward test, letter number sequencing, and I'll be just briefing on yoga intervention, what we have used, and what was the statistical analysis which we found. Next slide, please. So the subjects which we used were, we conducted one group intervention, pre-test, post-test, among 36 adolescents aged 12 to 13 years, that is grading to 7, a rural residential school in Udupi, Karnataka, South India, as there was very difficult to get the permission from the school. we got very, only 1 to 2 schools which was giving permission to conduct the intervention. In the Indian educational system, we consider 7th grade to be from the primary to high school, which is very benchmark. And during this period, students face a lot of cognitive challenges due to the abrupt complexity in the academic curriculum. Hence, we hypothesized that yoga intervention might be helpful to the students to improve their cognitive ability. Due to the potential benefit of yoga on general well-being, we have not considered the use of control group in this study. Next slide, please. The permissions which we had to take from the ethical institution of Manipal, then once we got the ethical permission from Manipal, we have registered it to Clinical Trial Residents of India. Prior to the subject which were conducted, we took a concern from the parents, and I said concern was started from the adolescents. Adolescents in 7th grade and those willing to participate were included in the study. We excluded those participants who were already practicing any form of yoga daily. So the next slide, please. So as I told, we use two tools here. That is, one is digital span forward and backward test. That is WISCOMS-4 that assists the auditory short-term memory, sequencing ability, attention, and focus. Digital forward test is used to examine the rote learning, memory, attention, encoding, and auditory processing. In contrast, the digital span backward test assesses working memory, information transformation, mental manipulation, and visual pattern imagination. The next says about the letter number sequencing. Its task involves the sequencing mental manipulation, attention, short-term auditory memories, visual spatial imagination, and processing speed. The single trained and calibrated investigator administered in the form of questionnaires as per the standard guidelines in the quite isolated room at the baseline and after 12 weeks. So before I go to the yoga practice, as I said, a questionnaire was given to the students prior to the study and after 12 weeks. Once the questionnaire was given, as the assessment was completed, we gave a yoga module, which was priorly discussed and formulated. And the postures involves Swastikasana, Vajrasana, Supta Vajrasana, Tadasana, Trikonasana, Paschimottanasana, Purvottanasana, Makarasana, Bhujangasana, Shalabhasana, and Dhanurasana. All these postures will not only help in improving their physical, but also the mental ability, and followed with pranayama, which is basically for the breath control to improving the respiratory function that involves the alternative breathing technique, that is anuloma viloma pranayama, one nostril breathing, that is Surya Vedana, followed with the kriya that is called as Kapalabhati Kriya, and a relaxation technique called as Shavasana. All these were conducted for at least 1 hour and continuously for 5 days in a week for a span of 12 weeks at the school premises only. Next slide. The analysis which was done, all the data were analyzed using SPPS version 20. A p-value of less than 0.05 was considered to be statistically significant. We used the Speculo-Wilk test to check the normality of the data, and comparison of the mean value of the outcome scores were made using Wilkonstein rank test. Next slide. Coming to the results, as we had no dropouts because only a few students were there and it was compulsory for them to be enrolled. So there was no dropout, so we didn't have much difficulty in getting the data. And all the participants who were in the group were appeared to be very healthy, and the seventh grade students only. Our students included 9 of boys and 17 of girls with a mean age of 12.19 plus or minus 0.04, that is 0.04. And comparison of mean digital span forward test and the backward test and letter number sequencing significantly higher scored in post test than in pre-test. We have got that result of improved in the post test, and continuous yoga practice over 12 weeks showed very good result in cognitive function. Next slide, please. Coming to the discussion, we aim to evaluate the effect of yoga on attention memory among adolescents. The objectives were to examine the difference in the level of attention and memory before and after yoga intervention. We hypothesized that there would be no significant difference in concentration and short-term memory due to yoga intervention. Next slide, please. Our research showed a significant improvement, as I said, in cognitive, that is attention and memory, reflected by higher score in digital span and letter number sequencing after 12 weeks of yoga practice. The results are in agreement with the existing literature. However, direct comparison of the finding of our study was not possible due to substantial variation in social demographic characteristic and outward outcome measures used. Nevertheless, the cognitive outcome showed improvement when yoga is practiced among children and adolescents. Next slide. Coming to a few literature review which we did before we started the study, a few studies shows that who practices Raja Yoga. Raja Yoga is the same practice method which we saw in this for a longer duration. It shows a significant fewer neuroticism symptoms, scored higher on hope and happiness and cognitive function than those who practice Raja Yoga for short duration. So I specify that you have to practice it for longer duration to get a positive result. One more study showed that the higher cognitive function, that is on concentration, attention, working among children practicing yoga and meditation. Narendra et al. Concluded that yoga practicing group showed a significant improvement in various cognitive function among adults, reported a significantly higher concentration level and improved short-term memory among adolescents who practice yoga for 7 weeks. Next. However, few studies reported a lack of significant improvement in cognition. Chaya et al. Reported no significant difference in the cognitive performance between the yoga and physical activity group at the end of 3 months among 7 to 9 years old Indian children. Kim Broad et al. Reported that inverted yoga practices, these are the practices which causes the circulation improvement in your the higher centers, has no significant influence on memory among college students in US. Ferrario conducted a systematic review to evaluate the benefit of teaching yoga at school. It included a 3 randomized trials that evaluated cognitive improvement, that is attention, memory, and development ability for calculating effective size, which favored yoga over the control group. Next slide. Studies have also shown that yoga and physical exercises are variably additions to school routine. The current study, what we did, found that yoga training improves cognitive function. Yoga is a simple and low-cost, effective adjuvant modality. It can be readily incorporated into curriculum to improve concentration and memory while maintaining physical activity. Further research on large scale over an extended period would help to generalize this finding. As I said, what was a drawback in our study was a sample size which was very less because we didn't get permission from other school, which we tried a lot. So coming to the result, as you can see the table, it says about the digital span in pre-test and post-test, whereas the post-test shows a significant improvement after the practice of yoga. Next slide. These are my references which we took for the literature review. Finally, to conclude, as I said, yoga is, you know, excellent practice method not only yoga, even physical activity, which should be incorporated in school and to improve the cognitive ability of the students. Thank you.